Tweaking the design of an existing web page that is already in production is very easy when you're working with browser developer tools, but it's not really practical because you're working with code and not visually. And that is exactly where VisBug comes in. VisBug is basically developer tools for designers. It will help you prototype in the browser faster, even if you don't want to work with CSS directly. In this video, you'll find out exactly what VisBug is, how to work with it, how it can be helpful, and I'll even show you a practical example on an existing production web page where we will tweak a few elements so you can see exactly why you should start using it. VisBug is essentially a firebug or developer tools for designers. It allows you to try different things on a live web page by just tweaking visually various design details. It allows you to check the current styles on the page. Basically, it's a very handy way to prototype directly on a live web page. And this is a tool that is intended for designers primarily because it allows you to do things that you can otherwise do in developer tools. But this is a much more handy way to do those things as you do them visually just by using your mouse and keyboard shortcuts. And the main idea behind it is that you can actually prototype on a live actual production version of your website without having to know how to code, without having to use developer tools to tweak various CSS properties, various values. Basically, it's a tool that will help you give feedback to developers as a designer. Or even if you're a web developer and you're building a page for your side project, you can use VisBug to prototype directly in the browser on the code you already have, change the layout, tweak some settings, tweak some options, and then get a little bit better version than you currently have. And of course, after you're done, you can implement that in your code, in your CSS. VisBug works almost like a design tool, like Figma or Photoshop, and allows you to tweak the design, but directly on the live production webpage. At the core, this is a browser extension, and you install it as you would with any other browser extension. Link is right here. I'm gonna open it, and I'm gonna add VisBug to Chrome browser because I'm currently using Chrome. VisBug should be available for other browsers as well. So if you're using a different browser like Firefox or Safari, it should be available for those as well. In any case, I will add it to Chrome. And once I add it, it will appear here in my toolbar. And as you see right here in the info, you can use Option Shift D shortcut to invoke it directly on any web page that you visit. I will go back to the GitHub page. I can open it directly by using Option Shift D or Alt Shift D if you're on Windows. And there it is, the sidebar. You can drag it around and put it anywhere you'd like. I will open the playground created specifically for VisBug where you can explore and test out all the VisBug features, visbug.web.app. And here are various tools that are available within the VisBug, and those are very similar to the ones that you would see in the editing software like in Figma or Photoshop. But in any case, if you hover over those icons, you're going to see exactly what each option is and how you can use it. The idea behind VisBug is to use it with keyboard shortcuts. This is exactly why you'll see on every tool that is available here the keyboard shortcut associated with it. Guide is, for example, G key, and if you just press the G key, you will select the measurement tool, and then as you're hovering various elements on the page, you will see how they are highlighted and how they are aligned. If you click any of those elements and then hover over a different element, you're going to see exactly what is the distance between those two elements, and you can verify that those values are exactly as they should be, as they're specified in the design. And if they're not, well, you can give that feedback to your developers and tell them to, well, adjust the spacing because it's not as it's supposed to be. Just a silly little example. Once you select a certain element, you can navigate to a different element by using a tab key. So let me try this. As you can see, various elements on the same level are selected, and those are the actual elements from the DOM which you're selecting here that you can edit then. And of course, you can use Shift Tab to select the previous element. If you want to go inside of a certain element, for example, let's go into this keyword navigation section here. I'm going to press Enter, and then first child element is going to be selected. Again, you can use Tab key to select different elements, or if you want to go level up in the DOM tree, or if you want to select a parent element, you would hit Shift Enter, and then you would go again to the parent selection. This is quite a handy way to actually traverse different elements. I will not go over every tool that is available here. I'll just show you a couple of different ones, but you should explore each one of those by yourself because they're really handy. The second one is Inspect tool that allows you to peek into current styles of an element As you hover in different elements, you're going to see style sheets associated with that particular element. And if for any reason you want to keep the current pop-up on the page, you just click with the mouse button and it's going to be pinned on the page while you can hover other elements as well. A very handy thing about this is that, as you'll see in a bit, you can actually see also the change styles. If you're going to be tweaking something, you're going to see exactly on this information pop-up which styles have been tweaked. I'll show you this in a bit, but for now, let's try next tool, and this is accessibility tool that allows you to check, well, specifically contrast between different elements. And this is not always working ideally because it doesn't always pick up the correct background that the text is on. For example, if I hover this text here, you're going to see that foreground is this black color while the background is detected as white while it's clearly this gray. So we might have a contrast issue here. Just something to keep in mind. It's not always going to work ideally, but it's going to work very well in a lot of cases, and it's going to be certainly very helpful for you. Next tool that we have here is move tool, and this actually allows you to move elements around in the DOM. And as you see in the information pop-up, you select this tool by using the V key. And for this example, I'm going to select this item right here, and I will very quickly change this color so you can see exactly on which item I'm working on. And now if I want to move this element in the DOM order, I can just use left and right arrow keys. As you can see right here, I'm pressing right and left key, and this is changing order in the DOM. It's a very handy way to actually test how your layout looks if you tweak the position of headline and subheadline or anything like that. And while you're working with a certain tool, if ever those labels or those outlines get in the way, you can press Control key on Mac, and those outlines and those labels will be temporarily hidden. I think that on Windows this should be Alt key, but if it's not, please correct me in the comments. Next tools that we have here are margin and padding, and those, as you would expect, allow you to tweak margin and padding. Again, you can use keyboard shortcuts, you select an element that you want, and by using up and down arrows, you can tweak the padding. If you're holding down shift key when you're pressing, you're going to increase padding by 10 and not by 1, as it's the case when you're just pressing left or right or up and down arrows. It's a really handy way to play around with margins, with padding, and see exactly if something makes sense for your particular case or not. And since we're working on select multiple box here, I will really quickly show you how actually multiple selections work. And as you can see in the info here, you can hold down the shift key and click to select multiple items. But there's a better way to do that using the keyboard shortcuts. I will select this green item, and the VisBug works with the DOM, so it understands exactly if some items are similar or if some items are siblings or not based on the element type, on the class, and so on. So I will hit Command E, and you'll see that I'll select multiple items that are related. Of course, I can select all items that are related immediately if I'm holding down the shift and then hit Command and E. All items that are related, or those dots in this particular example, will be selected. Make sure to learn VisBug keyboard shortcuts, because you will be able to navigate your designs much quicker, and you'll be able to tweak various things much, much faster. By now, I think you have a pretty good idea of how VisBug works. I will not go into detail of other tools that are available. I will just quickly show them to you. So we have Flexbox Align, Hue Shift, Shadows. Then we have Position, a way to move elements around, reposition them, maybe align them a little bit better. And we, of course, have Font Styles. After Font Styles option, we have Edit Text. And Edit Text will allow you to change any text immediately on the page. And you don't have to use the E shortcut. You can just double-click any text that you want to edit, and you can edit it directly on the spot. If you want to change the copy, if you want to see how different call to action would look or how it would work in the context of the current page, you can very easily do that by just typing exactly what you want. And the last option here is the search tool, and this is a really handy way to select all elements on the page that are related. You can use class names, IDs, or anything that you would use in CSS. You can use right here. So for example, if I wanted to select all of those dots here, I can use Command underscore E class to select them. Let's try that. .cmd underscore E. And as you can see, all those elements are immediately highlighted. That is a really handy way to tweak multiple items simultaneously. And how is this working in practice? Well, let's try it out. I will open masterinlinting.com. This is the landing page for my course, Mastering Prettier and Stylelint. I can open VisBug by using the Shift Command D. And as you can see, it's right here on the page. And I can now use all tools that are available within it. For example, if I want to change the order of some elements here, I can very easily do that using the Move tool. So I will select my headline here, and I have actually selected a strong tag here, but I want to select the entire headline. So I will just hit Shift Enter to select the parent element. And as you can see here, H1 element right now is selected. If I hit up arrow key, I will change the order of my headline and my subheadline. And now I'm thinking I want to increase the padding here because this is a little bit too close to this text here. So I will select my padding tool and I will just add top padding by holding down the shift key. I will add 20 pixels padding top. There we go. And if I want to remove all of those outlines, I can just hold down the control key and I can immediately see how my design looks. So I think this needs to be a little bit more prominent. We'll change the font styles. I will increase the size a little bit and I will make this text bold by hitting Command B, exactly as you would expect in any what you see is what you get editor. So you can see how easy it is to play around with this design, to tweak it, to change things, and to see immediately on the live production website how things will look if you change something. If I want to see exactly the changes I made on this particular element, I can open Inspect Tool. I will hover over this element. I will click it to pin the toolbar exactly into place. And now I can open Local Modifications and I can see immediately that I've changed the font size to 30 pixels. I've increased font weight and I also tweaked the padding here. Another fantastic option in VisBug is when you're working with images, and I want to really quickly show you how this works. So I will scroll down to the pricing table and I have a number of icons here. Let's say I wanted to tweak those icons and change them. I will actually open the guides tool and I will select the first three icons. And now if I want to change those icons, I can simply drag and drop new images directly on their place. So I will open my Files Explorer and I will select those two images. And the beautiful thing about this is you can actually drag multiple images simultaneously. And VisBug will be smart enough to know exactly what you want to do. So I will drop them right here once they're highlighted. And as you can see, even though I've selected two images, the first one is actually repeated. So it actually is that simple to change some images or icons in this particular case to see exactly how your design will look if you change those images. And as we're looking at the mastering Prettier and Stylelint, this is my course where I teach you in detail how Prettier and Stylelint work. It's still not finished. It's in production and modules are released as I finish them. Next one is going to be released sometime really soon. And as we're already looking at the pricing table, then let me give you a 40% discount on already discounted pre-sale prices just because you're watching this video. So use coupon code VisBug at checkout to get 40% discount on masterclass package of Mastering Prettier and Stylelint. And of course, by buying this course, you're directly supporting CSS Weekly and my work. Thank you so much if you do. VisBug is a fantastic tool that allows you to prototype, to tweak your designs, to see exactly how things would look if you rearrange elements, if you change some sizes, if you tweak things, and then you can give this feedback to your developers or you can implement the changes that you make directly yourself. It's a much nicer experience to work with VisBug than it is to work with the developer tools because it's much closer to graphical editing software like Figma or Photoshop, and you probably already know how to use it. And before I sign out, I have a very, very important question for you. Have you already heard about VisBug or is this the first time that you're hearing about it? Please let me know in the comments. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Oran Yambor. I will see and hear you in the next VisBug tool, or rather, in the next video.